Guys, now we are going to see about the importance of the liver as a part of digestive system. So liver, which is known as the largest gland in the body, located on the right side of the body under the diaphragm, consists of four lobes suspended from the diaphragm and abdominal wall by the falciform ligament, connected to the gallbladder via the common hepatic duct. So in this picture, we can able to see the liver has four lobes: right lobe, left lobe, caudate lobe and quadrate lobe. So hilus, which is a portion through which the entry point in the liver, the hepatic vessels, hepatic nerves and hepatic veins all together entry to the liver through this point, and gallbladder. So the microscopic anatomy will tell us about the liver is being divided each lobe into many lobules and on triads. So this is the visceral surface of the liver. And the role of the liver in metabolism. So we have several roles in digestion. So it detoxifies the drugs and alcohol, degrades the hormones, produces the cholesterol and blood proteins, albumin and clotting factors, and also produces the heparin. So the name itself says hepar, which means liver, in. So plays a central role in metabolism. Bile, which is produced by cells in the liver. Composition: bile salts, bile pigments, mostly bilirubin from the breakdown of hemoglobin. Cholesterol, phospholipids and electrolytes. Gallbladder, a sac found in the hollow fossa of the liver, which stores the bile from the liver by the way of cystic duct. Bile is being introduced into the duodenum in the presence of fatty food. So gallstones can cause the blockage. So in this we have the gallbladder. So from the gallbladder we have the cystic duct, and these are the right and left hepatic ducts, which is being combined to form common hepatic duct. And the common hepatic duct will combine with the pancreatic duct, which is in turn coming from the pancreas, to form hepatopancreatic duct, which will lead into the ampulla of Vater, which is being guarded by sphincter of OD. And gallbladder, it stores and concentrates the bile to 10 folds and expel the bile into the duodenum, and which in turn helps for the emulsification of the fat. So emulsification of fat is nothing but converting the very bigger fat droplet into very smaller fat droplets, which we call it as micelles. Okay, thank you very much. Please do like, share, comment and subscribe to my channel.